current picture of our project looks like this. There are 3 commits and 3 trees, and under trees there are 3 blobs. There is master branch, current default branch, that points to last third commit. There is also head, and the head points to master branch. And of course, when master branch moves along with commits, head moves with master branch as well. We have discussed what is the branch and what is head. Here are characteristics of each branch and here are characteristics of head. Please note that the head is only one, but you may have multiple branches in your project. But again, head is only one and it is locally significant. Pointer itself is located in .git/head file, and default pointer is this one. Now we will try to move head, and for that we will use git checkout command. Please note that git checkout command is used when you want to change version of your project. And when you use this command, git takes specific, let's say, version of the project from git repository and replaces contents in staging area and working directory. And all what git actually does under the hood when you enter git checkout command, it just moves head pointer, nothing else. It changes contents of the head file located in the root of the .git folder. Let's now try to take a head pointer and move it, for example, to this commit, to second commit. And for that, we will use git checkout command and pass SHA-1 hash of this second commit as argument. Let's do that. If you don't know SHA-1 hash of your second commit, you can find it in multiple ways. First way, you can switch to GitHub desktop, click here on history and click here on second commit. And here in this section, you'll find SHA-1 hash of second commit. In my case, it starts with 44E0. You can simply copy this SHA-1 hash and then use it in git checkout command. Next, you can find SHA-1 hash of second commit in command line, in terminal. Let's clear terminal here. And let's first use cut command and read contents of the head file. .git/head. Enter. And here let's copy this path, this reference. And let's cut .git and paste copied path. Enter. And here we see contents of the master branch actually. And it points to last commit, third commit. And now I'll take several characters from this SHA-1 hash and use git cut file -p and paste copied SHA-1 hash. Enter. And now I see contents of third commit. And inside of this commit, we see pointer to parent commit. And it points to second commit. Let's get back to diagram. So here is third commit and here is second commit. Parent for third commit is second commit. That's how you can find SHA-1 hash of second commit. In my case, it starts with 44E0 and the same SHA-1 hash I see here in GitHub desktop. Okay, let me copy several characters from this SHA-1 hash. And now let's clear terminal and let's enter git checkout and paste copied SHA-1 hash like this. Enter. Command was successful and here I see large node. Node checking out and SHA-1 hash of the commit, specific commit. And now our head has moved to second commit. And here in command prompt you see that instead of master branch that we saw before, we see SHA-1 hash of the commit that we have checked out. And now we are located in detached head state. What does it mean? Normally, head points to the branch. And before this action, head has pointed to master branch like that. But now head points directly to specific commit, not to the branch. And this state is called detached head. When head points to specific commit instead of pointing to specific branch, this state is called detached head state. And here you see that we can look around, make experimental changes and commit them, and we can discard any commits we make in this state without impacting any branches by performing another checkout. This looks complicated, but pretty soon I'll show you what it means. In this state, detached head state, we will not do any commits at the moment, but we will try it later on. And we will see what will happen if we will get back to specific branch instead of detached head state. In this detached head state, we can also create new branches and retain commits that we create in detached head state. We will try that as well later on. Okay, so now head is pointing to this SHA-1 hash, to second commit. And let's examine contents of head file in .git folder. cat.git/head. Enter, and we see just SHA-1 hash of specific commit. Please note that before this action, before checking out specific commit, contents of head file were like this. ref:refs/head/master. And that was reference to master branch. Now it is reference to just single commit, second commit. But let's now examine what happened with master branch. Is it the same as before or not? Let's go back to terminal and go to history. Somewhere in history we have command cat.git/refs/head/master. Let's enter this command and we see that contents of this file, master file in refs/heads, remained unchanged. Master branch still points to last commit, this one. And it means that git checkout command doesn't do anything with branches. It just moves head pointer, nothing else. Let's now examine what happened with working directory and staging area. Let's go back to terminal and let's simply list files in our first project, in our working directory. ls-l. Enter. And we see three files again. Before our project was empty, but after checking out specific commit, we see three files. And that means that we have moved to another version of our project, to this tree, that contains three links to three files. That's how this works. By simply moving this pointer, we move to specific version of our project, to specific snapshot. We can check also contents of staging area. Git ls files -s. And we see three files here as well. File1.txt, file2 and file3.txt. And that's great. That shows you git checkout command in action. It has replaced contents of staging area and working directory. And now contents of those areas are the same. Great. Let's now try to check out first commit. And in order to find out SHA-1 hash of first commit, again, we can switch to GitHub desktop and click here on first commit and see SHA-1 hash here. Or we can use git cut file command, git cut file -p, and use this SHA-1 hash of second commit. Paste, enter, and here we see SHA-1 hash of first commit. And in my case, it starts with 6fb7. Recap that first commit is parent for this second commit. But let me get back to GitHub desktop for a moment before checking out first commit and show you something. Notice that now in history we see only two commits, first commit and second commit. Last third commit has disappeared. That's because now we see our project from perspective of this pointer, of this head. It sees this second commit, this tree under this commit, and it sees parent of this commit. It does not show us next commits that were made after this current second commit. And this means that moving this pointer between different commits or branches, we are traveling, let's say, in time. And if I'll get back to terminal and enter here git log command, I'll see only two commits. First commit and second commit. And here we simply see head without pointer to any branch, and that again means that we are located in detached head state, when head points just to single commit. Okay, let's now check out first commit. Actually, I can take SHA-1 hash of this commit from this section. Let me copy few characters from this SHA-1 hash, close this, and now let's check out first commit. Git checkout and paste copied SHA-1 hash. Enter. And here we see that previous head position was at this second commit, and now head is at this commit, our very first commit in the project. Let's have a look at contents of head file, cat.git/head. Enter. Here I'll see simply SHA-1 hash of the very first commit. And that means that we have moved head to our very first commit like this. Okay, so head is now pointing to first commit in our project, and this commit is a wrapper of this tree that has two links to two blobs. It means that now contents of working directory and staging area should be replaced again, and I should see just two files in working directory. Let's get back to terminal and list files here again, ls-l, enter, and yes, here it is, there are just two files. Git ls-files-s will show us contents of index, and here we see two files as well. And again, staging area and working directory are consistent. In those parentheses you also see change, here we saw SHA-1 hash of second commit, now we see SHA-1 hash of the very first commit in our project. And if I'll enter git log command, I'll see only single commit in history. And that's because head points now just to first commit, it does not see all further commits. That's how it works with git checkout command. You can pretty easily and fast travel in history and change versions or snapshots of your project. Now let's get back to master branch and move head pointer back to master, as it was before at the beginning of this lecture. And for that we can simply use git checkout command and pass master name of the branch as argument. Let's go back to terminal, close this, Ctrl-Z, let's clear terminal as well and type git checkout master. Enter, and here we are, we have switched back to branch master. Previous head position was this one, it pointed to very first commit, to this commit, and now head points again at master branch. And if I'll enter git log command now, I'll see again all three commits. And same output here in parentheses, head points to master branch. Let's have a look at contents of head file again, cat.git/head. Enter, and contents are the same as before. It is a reference to refs/heads/master. And this contains pointer to last commit, cat.git/paste-copied-path, enter, and here is SHA-1 hash of the last commit. If I'll open up GitHub desktop, I'll see all three commits here again. And I see that current branch is master. Okay, wonderful. That's how you can pretty easily switch between different commits and branches using git checkout command. At the moment you see that the history of the changes in our project is just straight line. There are three commits in a row. And we can just move head pointer between those three commits. Now it's time to explain you why do we need actually branches, how we can use branches, and of course we will try to create a new branch in practice. Let's start talking about that in the next lecture. I'll see you there. Bye-bye.